Go to the Tools panel of Affinity Designer and select the Pen tool. Quickly add a path. So a very simple path. Close it. I'm just going to go up to these options here. There's three options. I'm going to go for the third, and that's Insert Inside the Selection. So click that. Make certain that's selected. And again, with the Pen tool selected, simply go over here and add an additional path. And you can see as you do that, you can see it's just below the existing path there. It's the parent path and the child path. So you've got parent and child. What I can do, I can change a color. So I'm just going to go for maybe red. And I can do the same, add additional paths as well. So I just simply go over here and add another one. And again, that will be a child of this one as well. So you can create all kinds of different designs. Now, what you can also do is you can move them. So if you decide, let's just go over here to the move tool. Say I decide to move it, I can still move it around, but you can see what happens. You've still got that part not shown. So you can reposition it and create all different kinds of designs and still rotate it. And also what you can do, you can go over to the node tool and you can modify it. So if you want to, you can change the design, move it around, and also you can position it inside there as well, or keep it outside, up to you. What you can also do, you can go to layer and you can go down here to layer effects and maybe go for outer shadow. So with outer shadow, you can just change the offset there and you can create a shadow, or maybe go for 3D. So select that and then 3D there. And that's still inside the current design, that parent. What you can also do with that selected, now I can do exactly the same. I can go over here, and again, this option here, the third option, click that. Select the pen tool in the tools panel. And then add an additional design there. And now that, now if I go and change the color so you can actually see it. So blue is inside that path. So that path is the parent, that's the child. So you've got parent, parent and child. And you can still continue to move things around. So you can go to the node tool and then you can move that. And what you can do, you can also go to layer and layer effects, and you can change that. So maybe add that to 3D as well. Maybe add a bevel to that one. So you can see now you've got a bevel on that design, or maybe Gaussian blur. So just blur it and close. Please bop the like button. Any comments, please put them below. Also, what you can do, you can go down to this one. So select that one. That's obviously that path there. And again, go up here to make certain that's selected. So click there and that's now selected. It's not particularly obvious and you can just see a very subtle change, but it is selected. Now what you can do, again, go over to the pen tool and simply add a design to that. And you can see obviously it's blue. So if I want to, I can go there and change maybe to make it say yellow or orange. And also I can change, of course, the width. It doesn't have to be the same as the other one. So you can create all kinds of different designs. Again, go to the move tool and you can still continue to move it around. Also, what you can do, you can hold down the Alt or Option key and duplicate the path. And it's still with inside, obviously, that parent, and you've got two children now inside that design, which you can still continue to move around. You can also go to there, select the parent, and you'll notice what you can do. There's an option here, Lock Children. That's quite useful, even though it doesn't seem to be. Just think, well, what's that? Well, if you move it around now, you can see the whole thing moves around. All the designs within that are moving around, which is fine. You can resize and you can see they will resize as well. You can also rotate it, etc. However, if you go to Lock Children, what you can do, click that, it lets you, yep. Then with that locked, now what happens is you can move it around and they don't change. So you can change that, move it around, reposition it, etc. And they don't change at all. Again, depends what you want to do. So Lock Children or not Lock Children, perfectly reasonable. And now you can continue. So go to that one. If you decide, you know what, I want to add an additional path, I can still go to here again, to the pen tool, and then add a path there within that. And again, you've got that design there. If you don't, now I've just done that wrong, so I made a mistake there. That one selected, make certain you go and select that. If you don't select that, it will just add it normally. So make sure you select that. And now with that selected and that one clicked and selected, now go and add a design and you can add that like that. And that is a child now of the other parent. So I can change a color. So let's just go and change to maybe blue. And again, what I can do, again, go to the node tool and you can move it around. Of course, if it extends out beyond that, you won't see it. So you can create all kinds of different designs. And of course, at any point, if you want, you can always go over here to another one and select that. Use the move tool, move things around, select that one, move that one around, and so on. You can just keep doing, continue to edit your design in all kinds of ways. Also, what you can do, if you're up here and you've got, say, this one, I'm going to select this part here. You can go up here and you've got blending modes. So you can go here, normal, and darken. So you can go through, say, lighten, and you can run through there. And of course, if you've got designs, you can move it around. It will change. You can select any of them. So select that one maybe. And again, that one can go for darken, multiply, and so on and so on. And you can vary that. So you can move those around. And anything obviously that's going to be affected will be affected by that change of blending mode. Likewise, opacity. You can change opacity, make it slightly fainter, and so on. So there's a whole load of different designs you can create by using this simple insert inside the selection feature. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.